buenas tardes. El día de hoy estamos aquí en vivo desde la ciudad del Monte con el único Soruyo. Vamos con el único Soruyo.
Too proper.
All right, guys, welcome everyone to another episode of Culture with El Unico Soruyo. Oh, Jesus Christ. El Unico Soruyo, Luis Adrián. Wait, what do you call yourself nowadays?
Just the tribal chief, the one and only from El Monte.
But you know what? The other day, we were talking about me and this character. I'm just going to say this character because I don't know if it's Luis, Adrián.
By different names, bro.
Soruyo. Muchos America's nombres. Sweetheart.
Hey, eso no es.
America's Most Wanted.
Yes, sir.
But you know, the other day, we were talking about that, you know, speaking of talking and what do you call ourselves now and all this and that. But you know, we were talking about the other day being bilingual.
Yeah.
And we were talking about being bilingual or being bilingual in El Monte or LA County or California or whatever you might want to phrase it as. But the question, I guess, is how did you become bilingual? You know, we didn't really talk about that.
I know. For me, it's a history, dude. It's, you know, I was born in Mexico City. So obviously coming here at a younger age, era just speaking Spanish. I didn't know a word of English and nothing. But for me, it was primarily, because, you know, in Mexico, como todas las abuelitas, las mamás que ven las novelas, güey.
Novelas.
La Rosa de Guadalupe.
Was it a real back
then? It was a real Rosa de Guadalupe. No, I was watching like that. Like, parents watch novelas and all that.
Yes.
That's where it all started. Con todas las Marías. Marimar, Mariela del Barrio, María Mercedes. Talía, bro. Watching her.
She was
her.
A goddess back then, the 90s. Yeah, Talía. We'll put a picture of Talía here, a 90s picture of Talía.
Cuando cantaba,
you don't gotta do that, though.
Es que se me vino la canción, la de Marimar, güey.
Marimar.
Well, that was that, you know? Yeah. Obviously, watching the novelas and watching como, like, how they acted.
Yeah.
And, like, I was interested in them, but translate that to when I got here, you know, coming from Mexico to here, the first thing that I was able to see was this thing right here, WWF.
And that's right.
The thing that grasped me my attention was not only how they were able to perform, but the language that they used. Because if you realize it, you go to school, but through wrestling, dude, you're able to get certain words that they don't teach you in school.
No, they don't teach you. They taught us a lot of bad words back in the 90s.
That without question.
Big shout out to The Rock. Well, I think speaking of nicknames, he goes by Dwayne now. Or no, The Rock.
So many names.
Dwayne Johnson.
The final boss.
Me, he's still The Rock. The Rock, Stone Cold, you know, The Undertaker.
Oh, yeah.
And then you had WCW too back then, and those, you know. So it definitely a lot of different dialogue as opposed to, you know, watching novelas growing up as a child.
Give me a challenge, because I want to do a challenge for next episode. I've been thinking of a challenge.
Man. You got to keep your clothes on, man.
No, that kind of challenge. Soruyo, we're talking about a different challenge. This is a different Soruyo.
This is, I guess, new year. Wait, new year, new you?
New year, new me. Yes.
It's kind of late. It's September.
We're about this to start a new year, bro.
This is my clock, by the way.
That's your clock? Yeah, that's a nice clock, bro.
It's a skin clock.
It's a skin clock.
Skin clock. Maybe it's Maybelline.
Yep.
But you know what? It's good to have Unico Soruyo back.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us on this episode of Culture, and we'll see you guys on the next one.
Tune in, everybody. Subscribe.